Walker.
All right, gentlemen, these are in the house.
Cousin Marv, thanks for the drink, huh?
Originally, the story had been set in Boston, but there are a lot of films set in Boston in which there are bars and guns. So everybody just said, you know what, can we go someplace else with it? We looked into a couple locations, but Brooklyn was the one that spoke to all of us.
With the location hunting, I saw Brooklyn from bar to bar to bar. I've never seen so many bars in my life.
A drop bar is where all the city's dirty money from all the underhanded things, from prostitution to drugs to illegal betting. The gang bosses congregate all the money and keep it there until they're ready to move it out.
I had heard something about it years ago, so I just ran with it.
Yeah, you handle the drop.
Which night?
Super Bowl.
It's a dark fairy tale, but it very much could begin once upon a time in Brooklyn.
Brooklyn isn't something you see a lot. We thought, what a better place to make a movie than Brooklyn.
Somebody robbed my bar.
Don't want to stereotype, but yeah, the mob was based in downtown Brooklyn. Then it was Bensonhurst, the neighborhood across. It was like that at one stage, but that's not Brooklyn. It's a super place to live.
Glory days. Glory days. Glory days.
The people that come into this bar have been here for 15 to 16 years. You have your regulars that sit at the exact same place every day.
It is an extended family atmosphere. They would say, I need a favor. And they go, is the guy from the neighborhood? And that makes a big difference. Now, all of a sudden, we're this hotspot community.
All right, quiet, please, rolling.
If you walk the streets of Brooklyn today,
how you doing?
You hear so many different influences, and I think that's accurately reflected in the movie, and we kind of wanted it.
Cheers.
Salute.
There's absolutely the Brooklyn attitude and vibe, and that sort of comes in both in terms of the accents of the characters and just the overall spirit of the movie.
She can't pay a tab tonight. She don't come back in here until she does.
But she can't afford it, you know?
I'm gonna start crying now.
Brooklyn is it's very filmic.
Without Brooklyn, the movie would have looked in a visual way differently. And before the production starts, we always like to look at some painters because painters spend time in analyzing and research the colors and the textures of the place where they start painting. We spend a lot of time looking at paintings by George Bellows, who's this great Brooklyn painter. And we saw a beautiful color palette that I start to recognize still today in Brooklyn.
We looked at his paintings and used that as a reference and general inspiration in terms of how you would put contrast in a scene. Also, lighting-wise, I play with oranges and blues, which Bellows would use in his night paintings.
It's the blue, it's a certain red, it's a certain light.
We also use a classic painting technique to have a darker background, and whatever is inside the set will automatically pop out more.
I love being out in real locations, because it just brings so much more into it. And you can just go in there and eat and breathe and drink in the atmosphere and the environment.
I think the city definitely becomes a character in the film. It's gritty, its energy is alive, it feels like it's its own kind of animal.
If you walk the streets of Brooklyn today, there's a real immigrant vibe from many different cultures, and that's accurately reflected in the movie.
It's a big place. It's a place that's real, that's extremely energetic, and it's palpable. And I don't think it's been captured with the specificity that it is captured in this film.